When I walked out of The Last Jedi, I had mixed feelings about what I had just seen. There were amazing scenes and impressive moments of storytelling, but certain elements felt weird or out of place to me. Yet, as I've had more time to think about the movie, and I've read or heard other people's opinions, I've come to love Rian Johnson's take on the Star Wars franchise. While The Force Awakens was a fun and well-made blockbuster that was a breath of fresh air after the prequels, it has poorly aged in my opinion. It becomes more apparent as time goes by that the movie only works in the context of the moment it was released. The references, the tone, the copying of A New Hope, mystery building, these were all products of the state of the Star Wars series in 2013 to 2015. But I have to admit that I have no real interest in watching it again, as I'm not sure I can get anything out of it until this new trilogy ends. I feel the exact opposite about The Last Jedi. I was struck by how much this sequel opposes its predecessor in multiple ways. For one, the movie aims to have clear themes interwoven into the overarching narrative. Even crazier, these themes seem to criticize what Abrams was doing with The Force Awakens. This film revolves around a simple narrative wherein the characters are racing against the clock and have their perceptions and limits tested. Yet, expectations are repeatedly dashed as one of the main themes is a failure and learning from it. Johnson seems to focus on subverting expectations, which has disappointed many fans and audiences. Criticisms about The Last Jedi revolve around how the movie has gone against people's theories and expectations. These critiques confuse me, because that's what I want in a film. My biggest fear with the new trilogy is that it would retread old ground, choosing to play it safe and appeal to fanboys rather than creating their own stories and characters. I want the fan theories to be wrong, I wanted my own expectations to be dashed, I wanted nothing more than to be surprised. Thankfully, The Last Jedi is surprising. While I did avoid trailers and discussions online, my expectations from the footage I did see were not met in the best ways possible. The lack of confirmation, the consistent failure and disappointments were refreshing, as their inclusion was intentional in proving the movie's point right. The opening of the movie is a comedic exchange that feels like something out of Thor Ragnarok, revealing the humorous tone, yet there is also dramatic reveals, intense action sequences, and serious character development. Many twists in the story and big reveals are surprising in how disappointing they are. They're initially shocking, but mundane and long-term impact. This play with disappointment reminds me of Logan, which may be one of the most enjoyably and brilliantly unsatisfying films I've ever seen. Characters in the movie die unceremoniously, past events are only hinted at with no explanation, and the world is ultimately portrayed as an ugly, unforgiving place, giving little closure or reassurance in terms of the character's well-being once the film has ended. The Last Jedi is not this bleak. There are tons of crowd-pleasing sequences, but in between these are similar, unsatisfactory moments. But just like in Logan, these are not unintentional. The focus on failure and subverting expectations all play into the themes of learning and reality. The film actively works to destroy the legends and destinies introduced in this franchise. The Force is grounded and developed, but not glorified. Luke Skywalker is not a mythical hero, but a complex person trying to live up to his legendary status. Rey, Poe, Finn, and even Kylo Ren are nothing more than normal people having to learn about the universe and themselves. They're young, naive, and flawed, and these traits and these themes are what made The Last Jedi engaging on a thematic and filmmaking level. Yet I can't say that the theme of demystifying legends is consistent. Many of the old guard, like Leia and Luke, get moments to look like badasses, in sequences that are admittedly well done and memorable. The issue is that they conflict with what the movie is trying to say. Luke may not want to be relied upon to save the rebellion, but he ultimately does in the end. Poe is chastised for being impulsive with the decisions, ignoring the lives of his squadmates in favor of doing something heroic. At the same time, Amalyn Holdo gets a hero moment by making a rash, suicidal decision to face the First Order head on. While these moments are fun and make for the most crowd-pleasing sequences in any Star Wars film, they do interfere with the point that we should not rely on heroes or legends, and instead should learn from theirs and our mistakes. Yet, these problems still contribute to why I love The Last Jedi. Johnson has turned the discussion away from theories or cool moments or funny jokes. Instead, people are talking about their conflicting reactions, how well these themes are tackled, and the merits of the filmmaking. We're not talking about Star Wars as a blockbuster. We're talking about it as a work of expensive art. It's a big budget sci-fi flick with a lot to say, and it's not afraid to alienate its audience to say it. I hope Abrams can contribute to this trend into Episode 9. I pray that Disney allows Johnson to do more of this in the next trilogy. I want Star Wars to evolve beyond its influence and its legacy. We have 7 movies to return to if we want nostalgia. We need new, creative takes on this fascinating and untapped universe. We need voices like Rian Johnson to not make a perfect movie, but to make a different and ultimately impactful and memorable piece of art.